Welcome to another topic of linear algebra. In this topic, we will be studying A equals to LU and permutation matrices. For this, the prerequisites are elimination matrix, A equals to U, and inverse matrix. This all topics have been covered in our previous topics. Please check these previous topics before continuing. Now in this, we will be factorizing our matrix A in the form of N and U. Here N is our lower triangular matrix and U is our upper triangular matrix. Let us start with an example. Now here our matrix A is 2, 3, 8, 7. So what we need to do is get rid of this 8 to form it into an upper triangular matrix. So we will be using the elimination matrix E21. Now what operation we will be doing is, the operation is A2 equals to A2 minus 4 of A1. So our elimination matrix will be 1, 0, minus 4, 1. So when you do the operations of E into A, you will be getting U. Here U is our upper triangular matrix and E is the elimination matrix. So we get E A equals to U. Now we can take the inverse of E to get L. So it was E A equals to U. So what we did is we took the inverse of E and it went that side. So it transformed into A equals to L U, and our L was E inverse. Now we can easily find the inverse of this E matrix. E matrix is 1 0 minus 4 1. So E inverse will be nothing but 1 0 4 1. Again, if you don't know how to find the inverse, please check our previous topic. So this is our L matrix, which is nothing but E inverse, and this is our U matrix. Now we will verify whether LU is equals to A. So this is our L into U, which is 1 0 4 1 and 2 3 0 minus 5. So, and when we multiply this matrix, it is nothing but this row multiplied by this column will give us 2 in the first, and then this row multiplied by this column will give us 3. Now when we multiply this row with this column, we get 4 into 2, which is nothing but 8, and for this 4 into 3 minus 5, which is nothing but 7. So this is our A matrix. So now we know how to transform A into L and U, where L is inverse of elimination matrix, also lower triangular matrix, and U is our upper triangular matrix. Now we will move on to our next topic, which is permutation matrix. Now permutation matrices are the matrices that can change the rows or the columns when multiplied to a matrix A. So for example, this is an identity matrix. Now when you multiply identity matrix with any matrix, you get the same matrix. But when you multiply this matrix, it will change the rows 1 and 2. And similarly, if you multiply this matrix with any other matrix like A, the rows of 1 and 3 of A will get changed. Now we will see an example. Now take this example. So now when you multiply this permutation matrix to the matrix A, the rows of A will get changed. Now this becomes A1 and this becomes A2. You can see it has went there and it went on this side. Now why do we need permutation matrix? Because we need permutation matrix because if we got 0 in the pivot position, we need to shift that. So for example, consider this matrix A. Here our second pivot is 0, but below that there is the 1 here. So what we can do is we can shift these two rows so that it form an upper triangular matrix. So we apply the permutation matrix here. Here this is our permutation matrix. What it does is it changes row 2 and row 3. So now second row went to the third row and the third row went to the second row. So now we have a perfect U and it has all the three pivots. So if you are stuck with 0 in the pivot position, we can use row exchange. So originally our A had a 0 in the pivot, so we applied the permutation matrix to get the proper matrix. So now we can factorize PA into PA as L into U easily, where L is our inverse of elimination matrix. So this is all in this topic. In the next topic, we will study an example for A equals to LU and A equals to LDU, where D is our diagonal matrix.